So this next patient is wondering, how do you combine seed therapy with external radiation hormone therapy for an Azure patient? They have a Gleason 4+3=7. Their PSA is 7.8, and they were diagnosed clinical stage T2C.
Usual policy is to start on the hormone therapy. Historically, it was recommended to wait about 60 days before starting any radiation. More modern studies suggest that delay is not that important. You can pretty much do the radiation anytime when people are on the hormone treatment. So the hormone treatment is started. Radiation is then initiated at a convenient time that works well for the patient and for the doctors. It can go in either sequence. You can do the seed implant first, wait a little while, and then do the beam portion of the radiation, or vice versa. You can do the beam portion of the radiation first and then add the seed implant afterwards. Usually there's a 2 to 3 week hiatus between the beam radiation and the seed radiation. Different doctors usually have a policy that they're comfortable with, and they do it the same way over and over again. But again, the sequence is not all that important. The issue then always comes up with high risk. Are we going to stay on the treatment 18 months, 24 months? We're talking about the hormone therapy now. And this may be modified based on these new PSMA PET scans that are giving us more confidence that there's no metastatic disease. But so far, we don't have any real studies. So for Azure high-risk prostate cancer, typically the hormone treatment recommended lasts about 18 months.
So this next patient is wondering, how do you feel about shortening the time of taking hormone therapy from 6 months to 4 months in someone who is Gleason 3+4 and has a PSA under 4.5? They're kind of wondering when it's an appropriate situation versus an inappropriate situation for shortening hormone therapy.
Well, there's no good evidence that doing more than 4 months of hormone therapy in intermediate risk, we call it TEAL, is necessary. 4 months of Lupron is pretty much the standard. So there have been some studies using 6 months. I don't know any reason to believe that 6 months is any better than 4 months. So I think people would want to pick the four-month time period. One thing that is coming up with the new Orgovyx oral hormone blockade is people are going to substitute that for Lupron in these intermediate-risk patients. How long should you take the Orgovyx? Because when people get Lupron for 4 months, they're really probably getting on average about 8 months of low testosterone. The Lupron has a lingering effect after the Lupron shot wears off. It continues to go on for probably at least another 4 months. So if someone's going to do 4 months of Orgovyx, Orgovyx has a much more predictable and early recovery of testosterone than Lupron does. So should patients who are taking Orgovyx take it for 8 months so that they get the same amount of low testosterone time that all the clinical trials that use 4 months of Lupron argued were beneficial. No one's answered these questions, of course, but the duration of therapy that's appropriate may be different in people taking Orgovyx just because it wears off more quickly.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high fives me, high five, high five. Can you high five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.